The Himmin afl. The current top-tier polearm in the entire game. According to the wiki, Himmin afl means Heaven's Might in Old Norse. Right off the bat, I'll say I absolutely love this weapon. I barely used any polearms during my playthrough, but I did try the Iron Atgear, however you say it, and I didn't really like it. Little slow, didn't really like how much stamina it used, but the Himmin afl, it's a completely different story for me. It has reach, the glorious spiral sweep, it blocks well, and of course, that lightning. For me, it's the lightning that really makes this weapon extra fun. It's really handy, especially when you have lots of little jerks around you and they all want to kill you. Anyway, here we go, on another adventure to murder some seekers. Now my polearm skill isn't nearly as high as my sword skill, but it's getting better. But despite that, I'm continuously amazed at how quickly this weapon dispatches seekers. And this soldier? It's quite the battle, but I've certainly learned some patience when it comes to battling them. The Himmin afl parries the soldier's attacks quite easily, and yeah, sometimes I'm patient, sometimes not so much, and I try to get a few attacks in there that I definitely shouldn't. But also you may notice that I do have a Mistwalker and the Carapace Shield with me. It's just for comfort. It's something that I feel like, in theory, I'd rather switch to it because I'm comfortable with it and not die, but in my Crom video, I didn't switch. I didn't do that as a contingency, I just brought it with me and it was there for no reason. I'm committed to getting used to these new weapons so I can try them out and feel them in their full grace, and I guess ultimately I'd just rather die. So I really don't need to carry them in my inventory, so after I finished this little session right here and I went back to the house, I did leave them back in a box. So yeah. And yeah, as you saw, the soldier died pretty easily. It's always fun doing that lightning twirl. It's even not necessary, it's just fun to do. Now I know this right here isn't a seeker, but I wanted to showcase how useful the secondary spiral attack is for just easily getting rid of ticks. While I was randomly exploring looking for more seekers to challenge, I had stumbled on some more ticks. I never saw a sky jelly or anything, so I don't know where they came from, but it doesn't matter. They died, though I think the terrain made it so that the lightning spiral didn't get them as easily as it should have. But they still died. Now this next one is pretty chaotic. I spotted a group of seekers through the mist and jumped down to meet them. Turned out, it was four of them, and they were defending some mines. This doesn't look good, and they surround me. Seems like they're starting to strategize. I take a bunch of damage and decide to just nope out of there. But with a lack of stamina, it's slow going, and of course the winged jerks follow me. They try to corner me a little bit, and even though I have no stamina, I am able to at least kind of safely get out of there. And yeah, I did end up jumping down here, got hit one more time. I thought for sure they were going to follow me down the hill, but no, I got lucky. After taking some time to recover, I managed to get one of them alone, but the terrain makes it hard to attack them. And if there's one thing I've realized, it's that terrain matters to me, but it doesn't matter to these jerk bugs. So I take it to the ground and dispatch it pretty easily. Then another one I almost killed previously begs me to finish the job. But surprise! My old nemesis, a one-star seeker, wants to test me. We circle each other for a bit, sizing each other up. I decide it'd be a really good idea to test parrying with this weapon, and hey, it does work, but then it kinda just doesn't. I pop some cranberry juice and then try to regain some stamina before jumping back into the fight, this time taking a bit more of a Dark Soulsian tactic. I believe the term is dodge, duck, dive, duck, dodge. At this point, I felt like the fight was going pretty well. I could sense the determination on its face, but it just couldn't touch me. The seeker seems to get frustrated that it can't actually hit me anymore, and then it succumbs to my glorious lightning stabs. And then, a wild soldier appears through the mist. It's always fun battling soldiers, I think, especially when there's nothing else crazy trying to attack you from the left or the right or from the sky. When you just have a soldier in front of you, it's kind of fun. It's a test of patience, and even though sometimes I just don't have any, this time I managed to slowly wear it down, parrying at least most of its attacks, and I only occasionally get impatient. It's pretty satisfying seeing how easily this weapon parries most of the enemies that I've come across so far. Pretty much my entire playthrough, I've always had a shield. I've always thought it was necessary to really get the parry bonus and to actually block attacks, But I'm learning more and more through playing with different weapons that you really don't need a shield. Yeah, it's handy, especially if you're facing down multiple enemies, but it's not required. Yeah, so the soldier dies, moving on. This little jerk wanted a piece of me, but absolutely not. Then of course we have this guy trying to distract me with how good he is at flying, but I wasn't impressed. Here we have yet another soldier trying to take me down. At this point, I feel like I've seen it all, and I'm not too afraid of what these guys have to offer. I know what I have to do, despite a few incidents of bad timing, but it still goes well. I'll just let you watch. After running around for a while, I discovered these two dwarves guarding a lighthouse, and I pretty much tried to defend them, but they're clearly more than capable on their own. I'm pretty sure this guy came out of the mist to try and sell me some extended warranty coverage on my armor or something, but I wasn't having any of it. Well, that's pretty much it. No crazy climactic ending for this one. I really, really like the Himmin afl. I think it's one of the coolest weapons in the game, and I use it all the time. The lightning sweep is really handy if you're surrounded by a lot of enemies, and it just backpacks quite a punch. Aside from Mistwalker, this is one of my main weapons. Next time, I'll be taking the Frostner out into the Mistlands and testing that boy out. Thanks for watching.